Hello, I'm Dr. Ron England, and we're going to do an advanced video today. Hopefully I'll make it not seem quite so terribly advanced, but I'm going to show you what I'm going to do here. I have a tool here that I have been using called heatmap, which is a JavaScript tool. It's actually heatmap.js, and it allows you to take a large array, three-dimensional array, because you have to have x, y coordinates, and then a value to go with those x, y coordinates, and it can generate a heat map of the values on that. And it's a JavaScript function, so it is written in JavaScript, and therefore I would have to be able to do everything I needed to do in JavaScript to be able to output stuff to it. And here's the dilemma. I need to do a lot of calculations for this specific application. So in this case, a large-scale calculator that has to output into a large grid or some format, but then has to actually render with JavaScript is what I'm trying to solve here. So basically, the challenge is to pass a lot of data from a C#.NET application to a JavaScript. So let's look and see how this actually works. Well, I'm going to, the way this application works is when I click this calculate button, and I'm not going to do it because it takes a long time to calculate, it's going to fill in the blanks here. And those blanks are all being calculated in C# but rendered in the environment with JavaScript. So, to do this, I actually have to have a script manager. And in my button calculate, you can see my button calculate here, I have a couple things here. I get the velocity and the angle, which also I'm getting from JavaScript-based controls, jQuery UI controls. So I have to do it a slightly different way than I would normally do this with a just C#.NET application. Then I'm going to instantiate a class. Don't need to worry about what this class is. Essentially, the bottom line is that this class does a lot of calculations, and in the end, it needs to put the output to the screen. So I need to call a JavaScript function from C#, and I do this using the script manager registered startup script. It takes, in this case, you've got a few arguments that are pretty straightforward, and even this argument that I left blank, which was basically a name for the script itself, because I don't need to access it other than here. And here's the actual call to the JavaScript function. The JavaScript function is called drawHeatMap, and I'm sending it one argument, which actually I've put inside of quotes. If you see the little quote, big quote, double quote, single quote, I'm passing it a string, and the string is actually going to be calculated by this class, which is in C#. So let's take a look. Let's go to the implementation of this class and look at this. Well, the name should give you kind of a clue as to what I'm outputting here. I'm outputting a JSON string to the, so essentially if I can put it in JSON, I can get it out to the application. So essentially what I do in this case, and it's not tremendously complex if you know a little bit about JSON, is I create, using a string builder, I create a string that is a JSON representation of the data that I want to render on the screen, and I pass it back to the JavaScript function. That's all this code does, is put it in all the data that I want to export into JSON format. Now, one thing that would be very, very handy to do when you're doing this is, what I do when I do this is I first simply put a text box on the screen, and then I output the JSON to that text box. And what I do is when I take the contents of that text box and I run JSONLint, which is a JSON validator, against it to make sure that the JSON is valid. Once I know that I got valid JSON going to the output, I can then use my standard JavaScript, this is all written in JavaScript, ability to do what I want to, basically render the output as I want to render it. So as you recall, I called the function pressure is JSON, and I output to the JavaScript function drawHeatMap. Here's that JavaScript function, and what I simply do here is I had to do a few other things to configure the heat map, but here I simply said, okay, I've got these variables that I passed over in JSON. So this key line here is JSON.parse. There's also an equivalent function in jQuery called parseJSON that will take the data and parse it out as JSON. So Everything that was in that JSON is now in this variable pdata. And if you're familiar with JSON, all the variables that are in JSON are now accessible through standard object notation. The one thing that you got to watch in this is, so these are all variables, max, min, lift, avp, velocity, and angle are simply JSON variables that I put into that chunk of JSON. Remember, JSON, JavaScript, object notation. I also had a very large array that I had to output here. And essentially, what I need to do with this array is I need to do some scaling so that it's actually going to fit onto the screen correctly. And then I pass it to my heat map as data points, the x point, the y point, and the value. But those were easy to get because I just parsed in it the data from the JSON variables that I put into the JSON array. I'm not going to cover how to create JSON arrays in this case because that's relatively straightforward to do, and there's plenty of references out there on how to work with JSON and do all sorts of, JSON is not hard. I actually won't insult anybody's intelligence by going over it. Look it up. You can figure it out. It's really easy to do. That beauty of the fact that once you have things in JSON and you parse the JSON into a data element, everything in that data element is now accessible as a object through standard object notation. Okay, I put all of it out to the screen, and my result ends up looking like this. So once again, to cover the steps, I create a class in C# that does all the fancy hard footwork so that all that stuff is done on the server. Okay, I instantiate an object that will actually do all those hard calculations, and that class has a function that returns the variables that I want to output in JSON format. I call the script manager register startup script to pass that JSON over to the JavaScript function that I want to put this into. Once I've got into this JavaScript function, I parse the JSON into a variable, and then I can access everything that was in that JSON, and I can just use JavaScript to output it however I want to the screen. Hopefully this has been very useful for anybody who's been trying to do some making that decision between what am I going to do client side, what am I going to do server side. Well, server's really good. If you've got some power on that server, it's really good for doing heavy calculations, where JavaScript is not the most efficient to do those types of things. And then just get those results and send those over. And this will let you go between .NET and JavaScript really easily. Hopefully this has helped out a lot of programmers. Good programming. See you later.